a week.
In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Prayer to the Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful.
And enkindle the fire of love.
Please go ahead, Tito Mans.
Send forth your and they shall be created. And thou shalt renew the face of the earth. O God, over the light of the Holy Spirit,
we ask this Christ our Lord. Amen.
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 Amen. From the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. What profit would there be for one to gain the whole world and forfeit his life? Or what one can give, or what can one, or what can one give in exchange for his life? For the Son of Man will come with his angels in his Father's glory, and then he will repay everyone according to his conduct. Amen, I say to you, there are some standing here who will not taste death until they see the Son of Man coming in his kingdom." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please go ahead, Tita Helen, for the three pointers.
Yes, po. Friday, August 9. The cross of Christ. Faith in today's gospel. Jesus proclaimed to his disciples a complete faith that is, if you want to follow him, you must accept his cross and be willing to die for him. Please think deeply. Only through the power of the Holy Spirit and our deep love for God, the Father, can we live out the complete gospel of Jesus. Are we willing or afraid to follow Jesus? Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you very much, Helen.
Welcome.
Today's gospel is one of the most popular, no? One of the most popular, this phrase, no? What profit would there be for one to gain the whole world and forfeit his life? Yun. So ang question dito is, what do you desire in life? What do you desire? Personal choice natin, no? If I ask, no, what do you desire in life? At this stage of our life, no, may mga priorities na tayo. Anong gina-decide natin? Is it something worldly, prestige, money, popularity, power, or something spiritual, no? To help one another, to love God above all things, to be forgiving, compassionate towards others, no, or giving alms to the poor, giving anything, no, sharing what you have. So yun ang ano natin, ang challenge natin. I think today, no, in our stage of life, no, siguro most of us here ang desire natin is something spiritual na. Because ito nga eh, what profit would there be for one to gain the whole world and forfeit his life? Yun. Pero sa mga young ones, Inday Irene, Inday Karen, mga young pa sila, they're just starting, no? They're just starting their life, no? If I ask personally, siguro, what is your desire in life? Yun. Kayong dalawa kasi very young pa kayo, you're just starting. You know, it depends on our upbringing, how priorities, most
values.
especially upbringing natin. Depends on our upbringing. So anybody who has something to say?
Hindi, Irene, oh, very smiling.
Please unmute yourself.
Sige, totoo nga, it's true no nga. I think the background or the upbringing or the environment where we are brought up or the surroundings really matters on how we look at the life, how we look at the future even. So in my case, I could really say that I have been in my life, I have always looked up on God. So everything that I do, I always ask, Lord, is this your will? I that's why I really say that if it's God's will, everything will really come smoothly. And ever I make decision on my own, or it's not God's will, it's not that it is being there's a hindrance, but God allowed it, there's a purpose for it. But then as long as we come back to Him, He will always make us go back to the path He wants us to be. So God's will is always something that we cannot ponder, we cannot fathom, but he has always the good intention, only at the last moment, if not at that moment, that we can realize that, yes, Lord, thank you, Lord, that I am here. You have brought me here in this situation, despite the things that we have undergone, whether it's making us feel bad or something negative. Every time also that negative things happen, I also realize in myself, like if there's a person who have done something wrong or have already looked down, people have been saying that, would say that, are you okay? For them, like they thought that I will be crashed or broken like that. But then the way I see myself is, when I see that person, I feel more, I feel pity, and I pray more on that person, because why is that person like that? There should be a root cause. There should be a deeper meaning why that person is, and that she needs prayer. Nobody should might be praying for that person. So I need to pray for her so that this person will see clearly. So that's how I see a person, especially who is trying to destroy, or they would say destroy or break. That could be the reason why I keep on going, keep on moving. And I feel like I'm not crashed, because the Lord, it's really the grace of God whom I could really say that, Lord, thank you, because this is how I see things, and I don't easily put down or get down. Instead, I see differently, and it's the grace of God. Why I see it that way. So maybe that's something that I'm happy, so as to make me do God's mission. Whatever mission I have in this world, I hope I keep on doing while I'm still alive. Praise the Lord. I would like also to share, I was able to, regarding the gospel, there's a good reflection which I was able to hear, as we know that in this Bible, it's very, something very, as mentioned by Tita MJ, everybody knows this gospel. So this Bible verse is not looked at from the kingdom of heaven's perspective. It can be very confusing. So if we read it not in heaven's perspective or God's perspective, it will really be confusing. People can ask themselves, what does it mean to deny oneself? What is my cross? What does Jesus mean by saving one's life? And how can someone lose his life when he saves it? From the earthly perspective, these statements by Jesus don't make any sense. This is because earthly matters are the exact opposite of what is done in heaven. Earthly deeds are deemed to be sinful, self-exalting, blasphemous, and unacceptable before God. They are the matters that are made by man and do not have the blessings of God. So, what is to deny oneself? As explained, earthly matters don't have the blessings of God, and man does them to exalt himself with pride and arrogance. Now, to deny oneself, when one is doing something on earth, one has to attribute everything to God. That is, thanking God for giving you the chance to do what you do, praying to God that you do it according to His holy will, and in a way that exalts God, and always acknowledging that it is through the grace and power of God that you were able to accomplish whatever you have done. Now, that is denying oneself. Will happen to whatever will happen to you when you choose to know, love, serve, and praise God. What will be said about you when you choose God and deny the world? Will be done to you when you follow God and not the world? You will have to forfeit in order to do what is pleasing to God. So as we try to follow God's will, there are many situations that we will encounter that might make us down. But we have to continue because we know that we are doing right. You know, at the end of time, on the last day, there will be only two destinations, the kingdom of God and the fury of Gehenna. When you go to heaven, where there is everlasting joy, your life will be saved. When you go to the fury of Gehenna, where there will forever be wailing and gnashing of teeth, your life will be lost. So, when you lose the luxurious and sinful earthly life, you will be saving yourself for the joyous life in the kingdom of God. Then, when you try to save yourself from the troubles that come with denying oneself and carrying one's cross here on earth, then you will be losing your life to the fiery Gehenna. Let us therefore choose to lose our life here on earth for the sake of Christ, so that on the last day, we will save it and enter into the kingdom of God, where we will forever in great joy be praising and glorifying God together with the communion of angels and saints. So in losing one's life, there's another, it should be losing one's life for the sake of Christ. So not just lose one's life. There should be a goal, because this is for the Lord, for the sake of the Lord. This is part of God's mission. That's why we try to be humble or just be quiet. And that's it. So I pray that we will be able to deny ourselves, take up our cross, and follow Jesus. May the Lord strengthen and give us the strength to deny the pleasures of the world, that on the last day we will be able to choose and be part of God's kingdom. Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much, Irene. So very true. No? So, any message from Father Tito, Del?
Yeah. Father Tito, touch on the demands of the of discipleship. Just like it was actually related also to last night's, no, the cost of discipleship. So number one point that Father Tito touched on was the invitation of Jesus to deny oneself, take up his cross, to follow him. So this actually reflect the demands of discipleship and faith on our part. That the invitation to deny oneself, take up his cross, is the twin movement of one's faith, no? So just like Jesus, remember, Jesus emptied himself from his divinity to become human. From the time that he was incarnated, he gave up his divinity and became human, became like us, suffered everything, just like a human being except sin, no? Because he's sinless. And then he regained his divinity when he took up his cross, when he underwent his passion, death, and eventual resurrection. No? So, emptying or denying ourselves from our comforts, from our from the earthly desires and earthly happiness is actually emptying ourselves, denying ourselves in order to follow Jesus, to be his disciple. And we know the cost of discipleship, sacrifice, sorrows, humiliation, all the hurts, no? You have to undergo that, no? Rejection. So it's really our emptying of ourselves is taking up our cross to follow Jesus, to follow his footsteps, no? It's the entire dynamics of the demands of discipleship to pattern our lives after Christ. Then the second is, well, whoever loses his life for my sake, that's what Irene said, for my sake, it's not will regain it. It's not only to lose one's life for the sake of losing life, to sacrifice one's life for the sake of sacrifice. No, it should be for the sake of Christ. That should be the qualifier. You have an aim for the sake of Christ. So there's a certain meaning to losing one's life for Christ because it's to share in his mission. Then the third is the horizon of our life. This is what you asked, MJ. If you pursued each one of us, asking each one of us, what is your aim in life? At our age, separating the young ones, no? At that stage of our lives, our aim is really eternity. The horizon of our life should be aimed at eternity. That's what we're aiming for. That's what we're doing now. We deepen our relationship with our Lord because we are after eternal life. That's the horizon of our life. That's our aim. That's really the beacon that we are aiming for, eternal life, no? At our age. No?
Yeah. Strongly agree.
I don't know about the young ones because they have a different because at their stage they have different aim also, no? And again, the baseline data is the values, how you were brought up by your parents. So that's the our aim is really eternity, not the here and now. I was really touched by Father Tito. That's why when I listened to Father Tito, because I repeatedly listened to his homily in order to get the highlights of his homily, I really admired all the more Father Tito today, because of his choice of words. They're yes. so amazing. They're so awesome. They're so spiritually lifting. The here, it's not the here and now, but we are invited in our life, here and now, to aim for eternity. He mentioned sa Tagalog, and I really forgot the Tagalog version of eternity. I forgot. I will try to remember that. So the passion, the death, and eventual resurrection, he always mentioned that it's the game changer of our salvation. Because what would have happened if he underwent that passion, if he underwent that suffering in Calvary and eventual death on the cross? What if he did not resurrect? What will happen? What will happen to us? So we won't be saved after all. No? If it stopped at death, voila. So the game changer really is the resurrection, when he resurrected, because he saved us. He saved mankind. He saved us. So that's the invitation of the here and now. Our looking at the Paschal mystery, then the resurrection, aiming for eternal life. That's my answer, supposedly, MJ, if you have asked me. if you reach me, that's my answer. Eternal life. Amen.
Amen. So don't get us wrong, young people, no? Kayong mga young, don't get us wrong, no? There's nothing wrong with gifted with talent, with skills, with material things, no? It's your gift. It's a blessing. But the bottom line here is, you know how to share. Just like what you said, Irene, no? Compassion. Be compassionate. Share your blessing. Whatever your blessing is, share your blessing. Kasi nga, you're just starting your life, eh. You're just starting your life. It's not that it's bad to be rich. It's bad to, you know, to be popular. No. Just be humble. Number one, be humble and share. And don't forget that we have a spiritual life. And the aim of our spiritual life, no, our aim is to go back to where we belong, which is in heaven. That's where we are. I mean, that's where we come from. That's our real home. Yeah. And also dying our life, no, material things, dying or losing our life is not really dying, like killing yourself or end of your life, but deny yourself. Oh, denying yourself, denying God. So, amen.
Amen.
Tito Man. give us your thought, Tito Man. I know you have something.
Nandiyan na, covered na lahat ni Tita Bella.
You have still Marino.
Ah, Marino pala.
Oo.
Ano pala, ano?
Okay, magandang kayo dyan, Marino.
It says, during the 15th century, a rich and an educated man named Bernardino Realino left everything for Christ. At 26, he was already a lawyer, a doctor, and a town mayor. He had everything that a young man could ever ask for. When he was 34, he went to attend a retreat. And during that retreat, he felt an overwhelming call from Jesus to become a priest. Thus, he left everything to become a priest. And from that moment onwards, he devoted his life to serve the poor. This saint found the real meaning of his life by leaving all of his earthly riches and attachments in favor of Jesus. He found his heavenly wealth by leaving behind his earthly wealth. He knew that nothing compares to Jesus. This is an eye-opener for all of us who are so very enamored by material wealth and earthly power. Many of us are so taken by the things of this world that we take Jesus for granted in favor of this world. But everything from this world is passing and temporary. Someday we will leave it behind. We will have neither earthly influence nor riches if we decide to follow Jesus. We would be losing many of our friends if we follow Jesus. But all of these earthly trappings are immaterial compared to the life that awaits us if we decide to hear the call of Jesus. To hear the call of Jesus is to be willing to leave behind our sinfulness, our arrogance, and egotism. To hear the call of Jesus is to be willing to be present at Holy Mass and read the Bible. To hear the call of Jesus is to have the courage to leave behind friends who do nothing to us except to influence us to sin. To hear the call of Jesus is to desire to serve the poor and downtrodden without expecting anything in return. Are you willing to leave everything for the sake of Jesus? That is the question. Especially for the young ones, you know? For those already in the twilight of their lives. If you ask them, they're ready. Pero yung mga bata-bata pa, they have many things in their mind, no? That they have not yet fulfilled. But it's the gospel is very imposing. Whoever wishes to come after me must deny. That is that word must. See, must deny himself. It's not an option. It's not optional. You must. If you are willing to follow him. And take up your cross later. The young people, doesn't realize yet what this gospel meant, because they're busy with the world. But for the older people like us, who are being called to be saved, we do different things. Some go to church every day. Usually who attends Mass? The old people, the elderly. You can rarely see young people going to Mass every day. Of course, there are some, not every.
Yeah, there are.
And who frequent the sacraments, the oldest. Yeah, that's true.
Baby boomers.
Because when you are called to be saved, and when you are at the point in time in your life, you will start to realize that everything that you gathered, riches, everything, doesn't matter anymore, doesn't matter much. Realizing that anytime you'll be able to leave it to somebody else. Kaya the reflection of Marino, it was a man was already a professional. Imagine, town mayor, lawyer, doctor. But he was called. He was chosen to be a priest. He left everything. That's what the religious, priests or nuns, they leave everything, their families, practically everything. That's one classic example of giving up everything to God.
Just like the life of Father Chris Aylar, Tita Bell, you remember?
Yeah. He was at the prime of his life, now very popular and very rich.
Very rich, very popular. He owns a multi-million company.
Mm-hmm.
He became a priest.
And, he has everything.
And in fact, he was, he was engaged already to be married.
Engaged to be married. To a beautiful girl.
Beautiful. So.
But when the Lord calls you, the Lord called him, he dropped everything.
He dropped everything.
Everything.
Just like itong kaklase namin, I'm sorry, Tito Manny. Just like itong kaklase namin, the only one who became a priest in our class ba, na he belonged to a rich and famous family, and yet he became a priest. Rich and famous family. Mga old rich ng Iloilo. He became a priest. So, once you have the calling, no? And, proper Christian background. Yun ang ano. Just like itong sinabi ni Tito Manny na si Bernardino Rialino. He left everything just to be a priest. So,
yun. Just like St. Ignatius, di ba? St. Ignatius. Loyola.
Loyola.
He came from a rich family.
Maraming mga saints na who came from noble families. Mga noble families. They became very dedicated. They took their cross and followed Jesus.
Emptied themselves,
denied themselves. Beautiful reflection also of Don Marino, which is very, very true. So the choice is ours, talaga. The choice is ours. For the young people, because I think itong mga grupo natin, no? Itong mga the oldest na ng prayer warriors dito, no, we have decided already because we found Jesus along the way, no matter what happened during our younger life ba, because ito ngayon is bonus na natin, yung bonus years na natin ito. So thank God, no, that we have reached this age, no, and we continue to help the younger ones, to really help the younger ones. Amen.
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 Amen. So,
Father Danny say, fullness of life.
The fullness of life na tayo.
Father Danny's favorite word, fullness of life, horizon of our lives, the eyes of our hearts.
Yeah, the eyes of our hearts and the hearts of our eyes. So I think that's it for today's gospel and reflection. No? We have listened to your reflections, beautiful reflections, and sharing, no, your personal perspective on today's gospel. No? Beautiful message talaga, beautiful message. So thank you, Lord, for this day, and thank you, Holy Spirit, for guiding us what to say.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Tita Flor, for the closing prayer.
Yes, Tita. Marinig po. Marinig.
Yeah.
Okay,
Heavenly Father, thank you for all the graces you blessed us in the name of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. May we continue serving you through our apostolate work, and may we keep your presence in our lives till the end of time. In Jesus' name, amen.
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 And all together, please, glory be to the Father,
to the Father,
to the Son, to the Holy Spirit,
to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning,
was in the beginnings, now,
now and ever shall be, world without end.
Amen.
In the name of the Father,
the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Thank you all. Thank you very much. I love you guys. Thank you.
Bye.
Hello again. See you guys. Bye.